Hello and welcome in this session on conducting an action research. Dear learners, I am Dr. Gaurav Singh, your course instructor for this course. And in this session, we are basically talking about the steps to be followed while conducting an action research. In the previous video, we have already talked about what action research is, what are different types of action research. But here, my focus is basically to facilitate you for developing an action research proposal as well as conducting the action research. So whenever you plan to prepare any action research, whenever you plan to conduct any action research, there are certain preconditions to it. The first thing is that you should have a deep understanding of the system of education, that how the system of education is at your place. You should have an in-depth vision and insight into the schools and classroom based activities as well as practices, that what kind of activities and practices are in your school. You should have a quest for new knowledge through seeking solutions for the existing concerns and a desire for improved performance in a school and classroom. You should have self-reflective activities, which may include self-criticism and self-analysis, and you should show the willingness to affect changes through constant identification of issues that requires strengthening. Why do we conduct action research? Why I am focusing that every teacher should conduct action research? Because action research focuses on school issues, problems, and area of collective interest. It also is a form of your professional development. I have already discussed about it. It brings collegial interactions and it has a potential to impact the school changes. More importantly, when you conduct any action research, you reflect on your own practices and it also improves your communication. So what are the steps in action research? This is a very famous figure for action research, where you can see the steps like identification of the problem, gathering the data, interpreting the data, act on the evidences, evaluate the results, implement it, and then move further. So this is a cyclic process, means one problem occurs, you identify it, you gather the data, you interpret, you act on the evidence, you find the solution, you apply the solution, you evaluate the result, and you move to the next step. So let us discuss what are the common steps in action research. The first step is, what is the problem or question you want to answer? Which question or which problem should be answered through action research? Then you define the problem or the question in clear terms in a specific language. Your question can be general or specific, it doesn't matter. For example, you can have a question like, does the new math lab increase math grades or the math test score? When you define any problem or the question, you also conduct different kind of analysis that whether this problem is researchable or not. You can have problems like, do the identity development groups affect the students' attendance and achievement? Does a study skill intervention impact 7th grade's failure rate? Does the career exploration guidance curriculum unit improve the student knowledge for career choice? So these are, you know, some topics which have been taken from some action research which have already been done by some researchers. The third step is that when you decide on which topic you are going to conduct a research, you decide your research problem and you define your research problem. First, you need to see what others have done. What have others found in this area? So for this, you need to review the literature, to search the resources which are relevant, which are related to your research topic. So when you analyze those documents, those resources, you try to know that has anyone in the school asked this question before? Who might have informed? What is the relevant research in professional journals? What does an internet search find on this topic? So you not only do the analysis of the internet research, but also you explore various journals, you discuss with your more informed and eligible colleagues with whom you can discuss. You also try to find out a solution for your problem from the school, either with your peers, either with your principals. So when you try to conduct any action research, you try to collect the information which is already available related to your problem. Then you decide that why you are conducting your study, means what is the purpose of study or research? What do you want to know about a particular concept? What educational practice should have been impacted by your intervention? What students' outcomes are you hoping to influence? Will the study help you to make any decision? And if, then about what? So the purpose of the study or purpose of the action research should also be explained in your research proposal. Then, when analyzing a research problem and trying to find out its probable possible solutions, you frame certain hypotheses. So do you have any hypothesis or hypothesis about what you will find? If it is, what is your hypothesis? Or what do you think the answer will be? When you think about these tentative solutions or probable answers of your research problem, it basically also helps you to identify your biases, which may impact your process. What is the opposite of your hypothesis? What will happen if you are wrong? What kind of data you will get if you are wrong? So these things you need to discuss, you need to identify while preparing your action research proposal. Then, how you will collect the data? So you need to prepare a data collection instrument or the instrument which you will use to answer your questions. You can use any tool. It is always based upon the nature of your study. Sometimes you may require surveys. Sometimes you may require tests. You may use questionnaires. You may organize interview and use interview questions. So along with it, you also need to identify an appropriate sample size for your research. That from how much students you will collect the data, from how much parents you will collect the data, who will be in your sample. When you select the sample, you also select what will be the appropriate statistics to analyze your data. When you design your tool, you already know what kind of data you will get. Are you going to compare two groups or it is just descriptive? So if you require only descriptive statistics, you can use median, mode, frequency, percentage, etc. If you are going to compare two or more groups, you can use t-test, chi-square, ANOVA and all that. If you are looking at the differences between the control group and intervention group, you can use t-test or chi-square. If you are looking among more than two groups, you can use analysis of variance called ANOVA. So what kind of statistics you will use to analyze your data, you also plan it in advance, and it is always a part of your action research proposal. Then how you will collect the data? You know, there may be certain issues or certain problems for which schools already have the data. Attendance, participation in teaching learning, completing the activities. There can be a lot of issues about which schools have the data. So you need not to collect the data, you just need to identify the data and try to analyze it. But sometimes you need to collect the data through various measures. If required, sometimes you need to get permission also. If some psychosocial factors are involved, then you need to follow the ethical guidelines and you need to ensure an adequate and appropriate sample. Then when you collect the data, you need to organize it for analysis. You analyze it and interpret it. You use statistics to analyze the data. You use graphs, tables, pictures to represent the findings. So what are the steps when you prepare your action research report? In your action research report, first you write an introduction. What comes under introduction? The overview of your research project, which may include the research topic, the reasons for undertaking a research, and what is the background from where this problem has emerged. So the background note of your area of research is also the part of your introduction. Then you write the objectives of your research. So here you mention what are the objectives which you are trying to achieve through your research. Then you write your research plan. If you are preparing a research proposal, you write what you are going to do. If you are preparing your research report, you write what you have done, how you have elaborated the school context, what you want to do and why you identified that, you write a description of that. You also talk about the research approach which you will follow, as well as their model which will be there. Then you write about sample and the methodology for selecting the sample. That why this sample is concerned to you. Why have you selected a particular sample and not the other sample? What kind of data collection techniques you will use and what kind of process you will use to take up the analysis. Then if it is a report, you put it findings. What are your key findings from your research? And you also discuss your key findings in terms of research questions. And then you write the conclusion of your study. Means how you can draw conclusion from the finding. You need to reflect how your findings will contribute to a change in educational practices. You also talk about that how your findings will influence the next cycle of action research. So there is a basic difference between action research proposal and action research report. What that difference is? In action research proposal, you propose what you want to do. So you identify a topic of your action research based on the problems which you are facing in your classroom or in your school. Then you narrow down the problem in specific terminologies. Then you frame certain objectives of your problem which you want to achieve. Then you talk about the research methodology which you will use to conduct your study. So you talk about the context, you talk about the method, you talk about the approach, you talk about the model. But for all these, you need to do the review. You know, review is always an important step in any research, whether it is fundamental research or it is action research. Why? Because review tells you that what has already been done in this particular area. What are the gaps which you need to fill with your research? It helps you in framing your objectives. It helps you in designing your research. It helps you in finding the appropriate sample. It helps you in identifying the tool which you need to do. So you give the introduction, you identify a problem, you write the objectives. With the help of review, you write the background note or background of the study, that why this study is important, why this problem has emerged, what was the context, what was the situation from where this problem has emerged, and you also explain the research plan. But all these are in futuristic terminologies, objectives as well as your research plan. Then the sample and methodology are the part of the research report as well as the research proposal. In research proposal, you propose that you will select a particular sample and you justify that why you are going to select that particular sample. What is the rationale behind selecting that particular sample? If you are not selecting the whole class or the whole school, if you are choosing a particular group of the school or particular group of the class, what is the rationale behind it? Why are you going to select it? What methodology you will use to collect the data as well as to select the sample? So all these things you need to put in futuristic term in proposal, and you have done in this way in your report. Then findings are not the part of the proposal because you don't know what will come out. But you propose how you will go ahead, what will be your program of action. But in report you put the findings, that when you conducted your experiment, you analyze the data, what you find. You can have key findings in one way, then the description of the findings along with the discussion which basically the justification of your findings in the light of previous researches or in the light of the review which you have done. So you can write like, in your research you have found this which is in tune with the findings of Mr. So and So year 2008 or something, or which is in contradiction of the findings of so and so. So here again review helps you in justifying your findings in appropriate way, and then you give your conclusion that I tested so many methods, this method is appropriate, I have done it in this way, this will help to improve this problem, this will help to solve this issue. So research proposal and research report for action research, both are important. First you prepare a proposal, then you conduct the research, and after conducting your research you give the report or prepare the report. So I hope that with this small description you will be able to develop a good action research report, as well as you will be able to prepare a good action research proposal first for conducting an action research in your class. I wish that with the help of both the videos, the previous one where I have talked about the action research, its purpose and its types, and in this video where I have talked about how you can go ahead, what are the steps, how you can prepare a research proposal as well as a research report, you will be able to conduct a good action research in your class, and you will be able to solve your problems appropriately. Thank you very much.